shared this morning and a few weeks ago. I used that as part of an illustration. Brother Tony and myself was in a revival meeting. A man had been going to this church for 30 plus years. Deacon, faithful every time the doors was open. You know, just you know, you, if you was going to say anybody was saved, you'd look at that man and say, oh yeah, he's right. Saved. Preacher was preaching. Me and Brother Tony, we stood up, you know, when the invitation had been given. Well, we thought he was going to help somebody pray. He went up there and knelt down himself. And then he went and got the pastor. And I'm like, now something's going on here. This is unusual. And he went and got the pastor. And this man, who had been serving, following after the Lord, faithful, realized he was in a lost condition. He'd never been born again. And friend, what Amy done, what Brittany just did, takes a lot, and I mean a lot of courage.
Amen.
A lot of courage.
Right.
And beloved, every time I give an invitation, I break it up into three parts. If you're unsure, you need to get settled today.
Amen.
If you're not saved, you need to get saved today.
Yes.
And then if you know you're saved, you need to get on this altar and pray.
Listen, Lord.
And everything. You need to know for sure. And I actually had a gentleman, he's not here today, but I had a gentleman call me up and say, I need to speak with you. What time do you get to church on Wednesday? And I told him about what time I got here. He was here waiting on me about 3 weeks ago. And we went back in my office and he was unsure about his salvation. And I went over it with him from the Word of God and he got the assurance of his salvation.
Amen.
Taken care of. Praise be God. And so, I tell you what, it's a wonderful thing to be saved, isn't it?
Yes.
Amen. And beloved, there's rejoicing in heaven over one that gets saved. They ought to be rejoicing in our church for one that gets saved. Praise be to God.
Brother.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Anybody else? Yes, Brother Jimmy.
You know, like what she said, you said, you saved. Your God's still on the throne.
Yes.
Amen.
You know,
true.
I thank God I've been saved, you know. They've been blessed with me and touched my heart. You know, that's where everybody should be.
Yes,
you
sir.
You know, they ought to pray. Pray hard. And that's what I do every night. I go home, I pray every night. And every day, God has been so good to me.
Bless him, Lord.
And I love his church and I love these people here. I don't know half of them, but I love them all.
That's good.
Amen.
That's good.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen. Amen.
Love thy neighbor. Yeah. You don't have to know them, just love them. Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
Bless him, Lord. That's good.
That's good.
Anybody else? I enjoy it when the Lord comes by like this and you feel the Spirit of God fall upon the congregation. Anybody else? Word of praise, word of thanks. All right. Well, if no one else has anything, at the end of the service, Brittany, we'll have you and Jeremy come and stand at the front of the church. I will ask everybody to come by if you don't feel comfortable shaking hands during this time. I completely understand, but I want you to come by and congratulate this young lady.
Amen.
For her courage.
Yes, sir.
And for her decision that she made in getting this settled. Amen.
Yes.
And so we'll do that at the end of the service. Okay, Brittany?
Okay.
But I think Dad's got a song for us before he goes to sleep up here. And so, Dad, are you still with me? All right, so Dad, come on up here and share a song with us. And pray for Dad. He's been like a weeble wobble. He won't fall down, but he's actually fallen twice in the last 4 days. And been banged up a little bit. Mom's been taking a lot of credit about keeping him straight, but he's actually fell down. That's where all these bruises and scrapes come from. But pray for Dad. He still wants to try to press forward and just wants to honor the Lord this morning. So pray for him as he sings for us this morning. Dad, love him. And let me get you that microphone here.
I'm a little weak.
Let's see here. You got your other mic on too, don't you? Good, we'll have you in stereo then. Amen. Amen. There you go, Dad. All right. Pray for Dad as he shares a song with us this morning.
I'd sort of like to dedicate this song to my son and
that's all right, brother.
Anybody else that may be going through the process. He goes through, you know, he always tries to be cheerful. Like he always is, but deep down I can see a change in him, you know.
Dad, hold the microphone closer to your mouth, Dad.
He's
you got to hold it up close to your mouth.
Am I losing you?
There you go.
That's
hold it was that?
I don't know where I was at now.
He still ain't got it.
I know that there's things that bother him and things that bother me too.
Sure.
But he tries to cover it up. I know him too well.
Yeah. Bless him, Lord.
What's going on? But anyhow, I'll dedicate this to all of you. Because we've all got trouble.
Yes, that's right. Yep.
It's a kind of a hard song to sing, and I'm not no spring chicken no more. The old vocal cords are just about gone. But I want to use them as long as I can.
Hey, that's good. That's good. Hey, love hearing you.
That's right.
Yeah. Bless it, Lord. Bless it. There you go. You can do it.
I'm got it.
You got it. It's downhill from there. All right. Amen. He restoreth my soul in the valley. Amen.
Yes, he does.
Psalm 23, even though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Why? For thou art with me. Praise be to God. Amen. For that promise he gives us. He said he'd never leave us nor forsake us. Amen. Well, if you have your Bibles with you this morning, Revelation chapter number 21, we'll pick up in verses 1 through 7. This morning we're going to talk about what a home. What a home. We're going to talk about heaven this morning. Heaven is a place of joy in the presence of Jesus. Heaven is a place of joy. Heaven is a place of no sin. And heaven is a place of reward inheritance. We're going to look at these four things. Beloved, the Bible says much more about heaven, but also it only barely scratches the surface of what heaven truly is going to be like. Amen. Our mind cannot comprehend the greatness and the goodness and the glory and the grandeur that's going to be in heaven. Praise be to God. Amen. Right. And I'll tell you, I don't know about you, but I look forward to beholding Jesus Christ and all of his honor and all of his glory. Praise be to God. As I said in the Sunday school hour, the worst for the believer, the worst that we'll ever have is right now.
That's right.
Our best is yet to come.
That's right.
For a lost person now, the best that they will ever have is right now.
That's right.
And the worst is yet to come.
That's right.
And so, beloved, this morning for you and I as children of God, we have something, praise be to God, to look forward to.
That's right.
And that's going home to be with the Lord.
Amen.
Revelation chapter 21, let's pick up reading verse number 1. The word of God tells us, "And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea." Beloved, this earth is going to melt with fervent heat one day. It's going to be dissolved. God's judgment's going to rain upon this earth. "And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God." And that's something to shout and praise God for this morning. Amen.
Amen.
To know that we'll be in the very presence of God for eternity. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Bless you, Jesus.
"And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said unto me, It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of that fountain of the water of life freely." Remember we talked about that in the Sunday school hour, the different wells. Notice here in verse number 7, "He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son." Let's bow our heads and go to the Lord in prayer and ask the Lord to bless the reading of the scriptures this morning. Dear kind and gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we are so thankful for to be in your house today, dear Lord. We are thankful for the many blessings that you've already freely bestowed upon us. And Father, we just rejoice and praise thy holy name, dear Lord. Glory, glory, glory to the Lamb that was slain, that you are still in the saving business. And Lord, thankful for what you've done in Sister Brittany's heart, dear Lord, that she opened up her eyes to the gospel light and realized that she was still in a lost state and called upon your name to be saved. We thank you, dear Lord, that you still are seeking and saving that which is lost. And Lord, we just thank you for so great a gift of salvation. We're thankful for your word, for your faithfulness, for your love, your mercy, and your grace. Lord, we just thank you and praise you for all the many blessings that you freely give us each and every day. Great is thy faithfulness, dear God. And Lord, as we look now to the bread of life this morning, Father, we're so thankful for this promise of heaven one day, that heaven will be our home for eternity. And Lord, we just thank you, dear Lord, that you will make things new one day, dear Lord, and that we'll be in thy presence forever and enter into that land and day of eternal rest and joy and peace, dear God. And Lord, I pray now as we look to the bread of life this morning, may our hearts be encouraged. May we rejoice and be thankful for the promises that you've given your children. And Father, I ask and pray that you would help me as I preach this morning. Lord, please give me clarity of thought and clarity of speech and strengthen my voice to be able to declare thy word. And Lord, I pray that you would give the increase to your word as it goes forward. And Father, I pray here this morning that if there's one that's in our midst that's unsure or that's never trusted Jesus as Lord and Savior, Lord, I pray that you deal with their heart. As much as heaven is real, hell is real also. And it is appointed to man once to die, then after this the judgment. And Father, I pray that you deal with their heart this morning. Draw them into yourself, that they would come forward today and be saved before it's eternally too late. And Lord, we just thank you and praise you for what's already taken place. And Lord, we'll thank you and praise you for what you're going to do. For it's in Jesus' name we do ask it all. And amen.
Amen.
And notice here in Revelation chapter 21, verses 1 through 3, and I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. It's interesting here in verse number 1 where the text tells us, says that there will be no more sea. Beloved, there's a different theology about this, why there is no more sea. But beloved, where are our sins cast at when we get saved? Amen. They're cast into the deepest part of the ocean or the sea. Beloved, there's some theologians believe that there's no more sea because our sin has been forgiven. And we enter into heaven. Praise be to God. Praise be to God. I'll tell you what. Jesus Christ conquered death and the grave. And he paid for all of mankind's sin on the cross of Calvary. And there'll be nothing in heaven to remind us of our sin. Praise be to God. Oh, I'll tell you what. Heaven is a wonderful place.
Yes, sir.
And beloved, there are different beliefs about this. And whatever you ascribe to is your business. But I know this, and we'll get to this. There will be no unclean thing, and there will be no sin in heaven. Praise be to God. Oh, I tell you, we won't know how to act. No more sin. No more pain. No more sorrow. No more tears. No more heartaches. Have you ever had a day like that here upon earth? Oh, I'll tell you what. I look forward to going home and being with the Lord in heaven. Amen. And notice here in verse 3, and I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. Beloved, I'll tell you what, heaven is a place of joy because we'll be in the presence of God Almighty.
Amen.
I'll tell you, I'm thankful for the Comforter. I'm thankful for the Holy Spirit of God that resides in our heart and seals us into the day of redemption. And beloved, we're saved by faith, but one day that faith will come to an end. When our eyes will look up and behold the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and we view the Lamb that was slain before the foundation of the world, our faith will end, and it'll be a reality when we look upon Jesus Christ. Praise be to God. He'll be the light that shines down through eternity in Revelation chapter 21. If you fast forward to verse 23, and the city had no need of the sun, neither the moon to shine in it, for the glory of God did lighten it, and the Lamb is the light thereof.
Amen.
I'll tell you what, we won't have to worry about LED lights. We won't have to worry about halogen lights. We won't have to worry about AA or AAA. We'll be in the light of the Lord for eternity, praise be to God. And his light will remind us of his glory and the honor and the majesty that is truly due his blessed name. In 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 6 through 8, beloved, the next prophetic thing to take place on God's calendar is the rapture of the church. But beloved, if the Lord tarries and time shall continue on, the Bible tells us in Hebrews 9:27, it's appointed to man once to die. Then after this, the judgment. And God may call us home when we step off into eternity. And beloved, you must make that decision where you're going to spend eternity in this lifetime. People say, well, I'll wait, I'll wait. Saying I'll wait is the same thing as saying no. It's either yes or no to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And if you say, well, I'm going to wait to a more convenient season like Felix, we never read about Felix again in scriptures. And as far as we know, Paul preached the gospel to him. He trembled. He reasoned of righteousness and judgment to come. But he said, when I have a more convenient season, I'll send for you.
Bless you.
We never read about him again. And Felix is in the devil's hell right now. Saying, I wished I would have listened to Paul then. I wished I would have got saved then. That's why the Word of God tells us, behold, now is the accepted time. Today is the day of salvation.
Amen.
Because you and I are not promised tomorrow. The Bible says that our life is but a vapor that appeareth for a little while and then vanisheth away. There's only a step between us and death. Beloved, you better be ready for eternity right now.
That's right, brother. Amen.
And if you're here this morning and you've never been saved, God is knocking at the door of your heart. He wants you saved today.
Yes, He does. Amen, brother.
And if you're here and you're unsure, or you thought you were saved and you realized you're not, don't be ashamed.
That's right.
Don't be ashamed. You know, the Bible talks about in the fearful, those that are afraid. Don't be afraid. Won't you come forward and have faith in God and have courage. And come forward and say, I've made a mistake. I've been fed a deception. I've believed a lie. I need to get saved today.
Amen.
You'll never regret it.
That's right.
And only those around you here today that love you will rejoice with you for the decision that you made.
That's right.
The devil is a liar and the father of it. He's a great deceiver. That's nothing to be ashamed of.
Amen.
Just be thankful your eyes were open to the truth before it was eternally too late. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
But if we were to step off into eternity today as a child of God, I hope you know for sure that heaven will be your home for eternity. And as a child of God, that's exactly where you're going to be. Absent from this body is to be present with the Lord.
Amen.
2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 6 through 8. Therefore, we are always confident knowing that. You know, sometimes when I witness to people say, preacher, I hope I'm going to heaven. I think I'm going to heaven. I hope I get in. Beloved, I hope your testimony is this morning, I know I'm going to heaven.
Amen.
And it's not based upon what I've done or my righteousness. I know because I put my faith and trust in what Jesus did on the cross of Calvary. He did it all, and I believe Him, and I've given my life to Him, praise be to God, and ask Him to save me.
Bless Him, Lord. Yes.
It ain't a hope-so salvation, it's a no-so salvation.
Yes, right, brother.
Therefore, we are always confident knowing that whilst we are at home in the body, and I love that word whilst, has some southern twang to it, does it not? Whilst we're at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. We are confident. Hey, we're confident knowing that. We're confident.
Bless Him, Lord.
Don't be unsure. Hey, I'll tell you, when I began my journey back from the far country, and it started in 1992, when I began my journey back from 1992 till 1995, I was unsure of whether or not for sure I'd go to heaven or not.
Bless you, Lord.
Now, God was working in my heart. God was doing some things. But you know what? God was doing a work in my heart. And it was a purification process that was taking place in my life.
Bless you, Lord.
And beloved, let me stop and say something. I'm not all that I should be for the Lord, and neither are you.
That's right.
Amen. I'm not all that I should be for the Lord, but thank God I'm not what I once was.
Amen.
Praise
Amen.
Be to God.
Amen.
And so, beloved, we are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord.
Amen.
And when you step off into eternity as a child of God, the very second you close your eyes here, you open up your eyes in heaven and behold the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Yes.
To be in His very presence forever. To be reunited with loved ones.
Bless Him, Lord.
To meet a gentleman by the name of Moses.
Amen, Lord.
To meet a gentleman by the name of David.
Amen.
And talk to others that God has saved down through the ages. And beloved, I honestly believe with all my heart as we have fellowship with the saints down through eternity. And you go up and say, how do you do? My name's, of course I know we get a new name. I'm just using this for illustration's sake.
Yeah.
My name's Chris. What's your name? I'm Rahab. I've read about you, Rahab.
Yeah.
Yeah, but God did a work in my heart. Praise be to God. He saved my soul. Well, Rahab, let me tell you what God done for me.
Amen.
And as we have fellowship all down through eternity, it's all about Jesus and what He did for us.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
In John chapter 14, verses 2 and 3, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you into myself, that where I am, there you may be also. Praise be to God. Heaven is a home, a place of joy in the presence of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. It's a place of joy. Notice here in verse number 4, and God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away.
Bless you, Lord.
Now, beloved, there's a lot of people today, you turn on the news, that are heartbroken. You see the tears. You see the anguish. You see the pain. You see the sorrow. You see the hurt. You know what? Some people, there's a void in their heart. There's an emptiness in their life. They're needing something. The drugs won't satisfy them. The alcohol don't satisfy them. Immorality don't satisfy them. Religion doesn't satisfy them. Entertainment doesn't satisfy them. Oh, if they could just get to that well of living water that will satisfy the every need in their life.
God bless
you. Oh, my goodness. I'll tell you, one day when we get to heaven, you know, I see people that cry over past decisions, over current circumstances. Just this past week, we've had some dear friends pass away, and have some friends that had family members that passed away. Oh, it's heartbreaking, isn't it? But you know what? There's going to come a day that all that's going to come to an end. And the Bible says that God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. And there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. Are you hurting this morning? You may be hurting spiritually. You may be hurting psychologically. You may be hurting emotionally, physically, spiritually. You may have some type of pain you're going through. Beloved, one day when we get to heaven, that's going to be passed away. It's going to be no more. Praise be to God.
Amen.
There's one thing I know that won't be in heaven, and that's Arthur. And he said, wait a minute, I know Arthur. You mean there ain't going to be no Arthur that's going to heaven? That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about arthritis. Oh, this past week, I'll tell you, my knees, my ankles, and my shoulders have throbbed and ached and hurt.
Bless you, Lord.
And no matter what I do, no matter what I put on there, no matter what I take, the pain and discomfort still there.
Bless him, Lord.
Now, beloved, I know one day that this body of corruption is going to put on a body of incorruption.
Amen.
And there's going to be no more pain, no more sorrow, no more hurting.
Amen.
Maybe this past week you've thought about a loved one, a mama, a daddy, a grandmama, a sister, a child that's went on before you to heaven, and you broke down in tears because you miss them. One day you're going to be reunited with them.
Amen.
And the next time you see them, there won't be no more parting. There won't be no more goodbyes. There won't be no more farewells. Praise be to God. Whoa, I tell you what. It's a place and a home of joy. Praise be to God.
Amen.
In 1 John chapter 3, verse number 2, beloved, now are we the sons of God, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that, and I love the word of God. There's no guesswork to it.
Bless him, Lord.
And we know, and we are confident, and again, but we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Isn't that good? One day we're going to behold him in all his honor and his glory. And we're going to have a glorified body like he has. A body that will not hurt. A body that will not sorrow. A body that will not sin. Praise be to God.
Amen.
Revelation chapter 5, verses 11 through 13. And I beheld and I heard the voice of many angels round about the throne and the beast and the elders. And the number of them was 10,000 times 10,000 and thousands of thousands, saying with a loud voice, worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing.
Amen.
and every creature which is in heaven, and on earth, and under the earth, and such as are in the sea, and all that are in them, heard I saying, blessing and honor and glory and power be unto him that sit upon the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever.
Bless him, Lord.
Hey, beloved, I'll tell you what. Don't let my praising make you nervous. Don't let somebody else's praising make you nervous.
Amen.
You better get used to praising God, and you might as well start praising his blessed name now.
That's right.
Because when you get to heaven, and when we step out into eternity, it's going to be a day of endless praise
Amen.
To Jesus Christ for
Amen.
What he's done for you and I.
Hallelujah.
And so you might as well start rejoicing and praising and thanking God now, amen,
Amen.
For what he's done for each and every one of us.
Amen.
Notice here, heaven is a place where there's no sin. Notice here in verse number 8, but the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable, verse 12, chapter 21, verse number 8, but the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. It's going to be a place where there's going to be no tempter and there's going to be no sin. Praise be to God.
Amen.
It's going to be a holy place. It's going to be a pure place. It's going to be a place of rejoicing, a place of honor, a place of grandeur. Praise be to God.
Hallelujah.
In Revelation chapter 21, verse number 27, and there shall in no wise enter into anything that defileth, neither whatsoever worketh abomination or maketh a lie, but they which are written in the Lamb's book of life. If you're here this morning and you know for sure without the shadow of a doubt that your name's been written down in the Lamb's book of life, can I get an amen out of
amen.
You?
Amen.
Amen. Praise be to God.
Yes. That's good.
Don't have to worry about any more sin.
Bless him.
Won't have to worry about Satan anymore.
Bless him.
And notice here, as in verse number, Ephesians chapter 5, verses 5 through 7. For this you know, that no whoremonger, nor unclean person, nor covetous man who is an idolater hath any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. Let no man deceive you with vain words, for because of these things cometh the wrath of God upon the children of disobedience. Be not ye therefore partakers with them. I believe there's a lot of people think they're going to heaven that's been deceived. They're not going to heaven. I believe it's not about knowing Jesus Christ in your head intellectually. As we studied in the book of James, even the devils believe and tremble. They have an intellectual belief, yet they still rebel and reject the authority of God. Beloved, it's not about intellect. It's what's taking place in your heart. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thine head, no, believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved.
Hallelujah.
It's a heart transformation.
That's right.
Old things are passed away. Behold, all things become new.
Amen. Yes.
Oh, beloved, heaven is a place where there'll be no sin. The Bible talks about here in Ephesians, hath an inheritance. It's going to be a home of inheritance and rewards. Praise be to God. Beloved, don't get too confused. They're different. There's rewards that you and I are going to obtain of what we have or have not done. We're going to be judged for what we have or have not done since our salvation at the judgment seat of Christ. That's why it's important to be faithful and to do things for the right reason. Don't do them because the preacher asked you to. Don't do them because somebody else is watching you. Do it because you love Jesus Christ.
That's right. Amen.
We love him because he first loved
us.
That's right. And what you do for God, do because you love him.
Amen.
Not because somebody else is watching or ask you to.
Right.
And the heart motive, why you done it, will be bought out to be the seed of Christ.
Mm-hmm. That's
right. It's a land of reward, but it's also a land of inheritance.
Yeah.
The Bible tells us in Revelation chapter 21, verse number 7, he that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. See, an inheritance, beloved, is something that's set aside for each and every one of us. In 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verses 12 through 15, the Word of God tells us, now if any man build upon this foundation, gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, stubble, every man's work shall be made manifest, for the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire, and the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is. If any man's work abide, which he hath built thereupon, he shall receive a reward. If any man's work shall be burned, he shall suffer loss, but he himself shall be saved, yet so as by fire. You don't lose your salvation, but you can lose your rewards.
That's right.
You can lose your rewards. And so, beloved, we all want to stand and give an account of our stewardship. What was required of stewards? That a man be found what? Faithful. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 9 and 10. Wherefore we labor that, whether present or absent, we may be accepted of him. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that everyone may receive the things done in his body, according to that he hath done, whether it be good or bad. And so, yes, we have a reward waiting on us if we do the right thing for the right reason.
Amen. Bless you.
And beloved, as a child of God, we also have an inheritance waiting on us. And I say this in closing. Colossians chapter 1, verse number 12. Giving thanks unto the Father, which he hath made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light. Not only do we have rewards waiting for us, we have an inheritance waiting for us. Oh, beloved, heaven is going to be a wonderful place, isn't it?
Amen, brother.
Oh, beloved, in the day and age of doom and gloom, and everything you hear about on the news is bad. I hope this morning's message has been some good news of encouragement for you. This is the worst we'll ever have it as a child of God. We got something much better waiting on us. Amen.
Amen.
And so, beloved, think about where you're headed and where you're going and who you're going to see. And, beloved, when you start thinking about heavenly things, you won't have your eyes upon earthly things. And you can walk around living a victorious Christian life, knowing where you're going and who you're going to see. Amen.
Amen.
And so at this time, I'd like to invite everybody, if you would, to stand, please. Everyone's standing, everyone's heads bowed, everyone's eyes closed, that the musicians will make their way to the instruments. I want to ask a question here this morning. Maybe there's someone here and the Holy Spirit of God has spoken to your heart, and you're here this morning, you've never been saved, or you're not for sure heaven will be your home for eternity. And friend, if you're here and you've never been saved or not for sure that heaven will be your home for eternity, I'd like for you to raise your hand at this time and say, Preacher Chris, I'd like for you to pray for me. I'm not going to come to you and embarrass you. I'm not going to call you out. But I am going to pray for you that you'll come forward and let somebody take the word of God and show you how you can know for sure, based upon the authority of God's word, that heaven will be your home for eternity. This place we just talked about can be your home. But you must make that decision today. Is there anybody like that? Say, Preacher, pray for me. I'd like to be saved, or I'm not for sure I'm saved. Would you pray for me? Just slip your hand up, put it right back down. Say, Preacher, pray for me. Anybody like that? All right, I'm speaking to saved people now. Say, Preacher, when you pray, would you pray for me and my family? Me and my family have many needs, and the Lord knows all about them. When you pray, would you include me and my family in your prayers? Would you slip your hand up? God bless you. I see hands all over the auditorium. God bless you. I see those hands. Dear Heavenly Father, you saw the hands that were raised. You know the needs of your people. And Father, I pray for each and every person that's here this morning. I ask and pray that your hand of blessing would be upon each and every one. And for those that could not be here today, Lord, you know their needs. You know their circumstance. And Father, I pray that you would bless them wherever they may be at. And Father, I pray now that you would bless this invitation. Have your will and way. For it's in Christ's name we do ask it all. And now with the heads bowed and eyes closed, if you need to come do business with the Lord, as the musicians play, you obey the Lord this morning. We have some that's responded, and maybe you need to respond. It may be a spiritual need, it may be a physical need, a financial need, an employment need, whatever it is. Why don't you give it to the Lord this morning? Casting all your care upon him, for he cared for you. Jesus loves you. He loves you more than anybody else, and he wants to help you today. Will you let him? There's still time. Come give it to Jesus. You'll be glad you did. God bless you, and all God's people said?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, there are two things that I need to talk to the church about, so if you'll be seated here just for a second. Go ahead and be seated before we dismiss. There's an individual within our church that's got a multitude of physical infirmities that's not been able to work for some time and everything. And so with that being said, what we're going to do is the church has prepared a gift to give to this individual, and we're going to take up an offering for this individual. They did not ask me to